we as a country cannot allow the mistreatment of our babies. I mean, you know, at the time that that happened, it was 2005, and I had a three-year-old. And to watch the treatment of a black baby such that she was treated like an animal, you know, we have to commit to never again should that happen. Unfortunately, 2 weeks ago, in Milledgeville, Georgia, another one of our babies, a little girl who is a kindergartner, again, for a temper tantrum, was arrested in school. We have got to reform our schools, but not in the way in which we're going. The trajectory of education reform in this country is wrong-headed. We are going down the road of privatization, which means that there will be sorting out of our children. Sorting that will disadvantage children of color for centuries. You may have heard in the past few days in Philadelphia, they have announced the dissolution of their public school system. How are we allowing this to happen? And so the things that we have to do is we have to be able to pass legislation that will finally close the funding gap that we have had in this country between our schools. My child goes to a public school in Prince George's County, Maryland. And I chose to send her to a public school because I'm a believer in public schools. I am a believer in the fact that every child is entitled to have a high quality education. But she goes to a school where one of my colleagues sends their kids to school in Fairfax County. And every child is able to avail themselves of a smart board in every classroom. In my school, John, you and I have talked about this, John Jackson from Schott Foundation, my child does not have one smart board. Her child was 7 at the time, and mine was 7, and her child was doing presentations on a smart board. We don't know what a smart board looks like. And here we have two children the same age already having different opportunities. If we as a country don't come together around our babies and make sure that they have the opportunity to understand that, yes, a black man was elected and that you can become that because you have toilet paper in your school. There are schools without toilet paper, people. There are schools without paper for copying. There are schools without books. This is what we believe our children should have. How are they going to follow in the footsteps of President Obama if they don't have the bare basics? And so we have to be able to really come together as a country to understand that our children, we have to invest in our children, because that will get rid of the double consciousness when our children are able to think that they are equal to every other child and that they believe that America is a place where they can reach their potential.
So